call it, Babe Ruth ball it. Your boyfriend's...
Everybody, I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Two teams will need their quarterbacks to step up and lead their offenses on the gridiron today. It's Rivers' Chargers going up against Palmer's Cardinals. And with that, it's off to the Valley of the Sun, Phoenix, Arizona, where we'll hand it over to our broadcasting team of Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Thank you, Larry. It hosted Super Bowls 42 and 49. And it's University of Phoenix Stadium. That's where we're at in Glendale, Arizona. Coming up, we've got a good matchup on tap between the San Diego Chargers and the Arizona Cardinals. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. And the back goes into motion. Now a first carry for Melvin Gordon. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine. Rivers now on second down. Caught on the left side by Benjamin. And he's brought down. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
That was a nice completion on an out route. And those types of plays are the result of arm strength by the quarterback and timing by the receiver.
Now Gordon on first down. And he'll get this only up to about the 35. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Hurry up!
Now a second down throw for Rivers. Right side catch. This is Gates. Well, Gates returned to action against the Broncos in week 6, but the young man, the 21-year-old Hunter Henry, starting to really emerge as Gates' successor, isn't he?
He is, and what I like now with Antonio Gates on the field, you bring Hunter Henry on the field, you can really increase your offense. You can balance things up so you don't know which direction they're going to go. They're starting to use them maybe like Gronk and Martellus Bennett in New England.
Gates 36, I said Henry 21, 15-year gap between those two.
My man, did you use a calculator or an abacus to figure out that age difference?
I stayed up all night on that one. You be careful.
Football's such a game of tendencies, down and distance, and on third and inches, third and one. You're thinking, yeah, fullback's probably going to get the ball, but when you get to third and two, most of the time that's either the running back or a pass play. So that's a nice tendency breaker by the offensive team there. Hand it to their big guy to pick up a first down.
And here comes play number 6 on this drive. Second down, Rivers. And he's got his man in stride, complete. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. And how about this first drive? They're being aggressive, slinging it around.
Really confident, too, because they're not trying to fool them with running plays, throwing it, and they're being very successful right now.
First down, Rivers. Got a man over the middle. It's Williams. 5 yards on the pickup, and it'll bring up a second down. And the pocket's been protected pretty good here so far in the opening drive.
We always talk about confidence in runners and catchers and quarterbacks. How about the protection detail? They're not allowing anyone near the guy throwing the football.
And he's brought down, but not before reaching the 8-yard line.
We can talk about bend but don't break all we want, but the defense now, we're going to find out just how flexible and pliable they really are. Can they bounce back after that type of a run, that type of momentum against them, and find a way to slow down this offense?
And this seemingly endless drive continues. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. First and goal, Melvin Gordon. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. Gordon fell 6 yards shy of 100 in week 6. 27 carries. Now, most of his yards came on one carry, a 48-yard run in the second half.
Yeah, I know the Denver defense will console themselves and say, well, it's 26 carries for 46 if you take out that one run. But Melvin Gordon and all the other great runners would say, yeah, but I did it. That run has to count, doesn't it? And that's what he gives them, that explosiveness on any given play that he can go a long distance.
Again, Gordon on second and goal. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Chargers. Melvin Gordon taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Chargers take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Now the Chargers are going to look up here and signal for a timeout. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter.
Here goes, blue 58.
They'll throw on first down here with Palmer. And incomplete to open things up. Larry Fitzgerald was the intended target, and it's second down. The inaugural drive for this offense today, and the guy we're going to talk about, Michael Floyd.
Starting to develop into a number one receiver, a guy that you'll count on downfield.
Get ready.
Second and 10, it's Palmer again. And this is Michael Floyd, complete. Give him 30 yards there. And now the Chargers are going to signal for another timeout. And that's their second charge timeout here in this first quarter. They're down to 1 remaining. First down and 10 now for the offensive group.
Here we go. Blue 58.
On first down, it's Palmer. He gets it into the hands of Larry Fitzgerald. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line.
Well, there's the first time in this game that Carson Palmer finds Larry Fitzgerald. Likely won't be the last, but how about the way these two have helped each other's careers?
Yeah, they really have. It's hard to believe with Fitzgerald, but really both of these guys, how long they've been in the league now. But Fitzgerald, gosh, third overall pick back in 04.
Yeah, how about that? Remember Carson Palmer, a former Heisman Trophy winner? He's finally found a real home in Arizona.
Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Now Palmer, that is caught at the 7-yard line. It'll be a gain of 9, and that is going to set up a 3rd and 1. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is it not? With his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play, but what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right over the top of it because he can see everything, and sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver quicker.
From the 2-yard line now, and he will get into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. Darren Fells taking it in from a yard out. And the Cardinals are just an extra point away from tying this game. It's good, and we're all tied at 7 apiece. So we're right back where we started. All even as the kick's away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. You know, this San Diego team, they broke a streak they probably wanted to break in week 6. That victory over Denver, they lost 10 straight within the division going back to 2014. That's no more.
And there's no way you can just take those 10 and throw them out. But think about the division they're in. The Broncos won the Super Bowl last year. You're talking about the Raiders. They have rebuilt now, and now they've become a contender. And Kansas City? That defense, trying to work against them, good luck. Yeah, I can understand how the streak can get to 10 because that's a tough division to navigate.
A first down throw here for Rivers. And this one's incomplete. He was looking for Travis Benjamin that time. That'll bring up 2nd down. Offense looking to avoid a 3rd and long. It's 2nd and 10. Out of the gun, Rivers. He's going to look deep down the field. And they went for a big play through the air on 2nd down. Couldn't connect. Now it's 3rd.
Well, they went for the big play there, but that drop could really hurt their momentum.
Here for the offense after the incomplete pass. They'll run it now out of the gun. And not much room there, so get it up only to about the 21. Give him a couple on the run as it brings up a 4th down. Back now to begin the 2nd quarter with Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin. It's the Chargers here with a football, but likely not for long as they're in punt formation to kick it away. Here's Drew Kaser now, as he's on to punt for the first time tonight. Ellington now to return it. A good return there, call it 13 yards. And the Cards will take over, 1st and 10. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were competent enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
They begin the drive with Johnson. And he takes it past the 45 and down at the 46. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. And with that, they're now out of timeouts, and still plenty of time remaining here in this 2nd quarter.
Deep. Sally 19.
They go to Johnson again. And he'll fight his way forward to about the 48-yard line. They got two of the three they needed there. Leaves them with third and just a yard.
Well, they held him to a short gain on that one. And it almost felt like on that first run, they were trying to just throw the jab at him. So how do you stop a jab? Get closer and smother it, just as they did on that last play.
That'll make it fourth down after a loss of one. Throwing is Palmer, and this is incomplete. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it, and the Chargers will get the football back in excellent field position. And now San Diego getting set to go. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with a game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to
There goes Melvin Gordon. And all the way in. Touchdown, San Diego. Melvin Gordon with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Chargers are able to strike for six. Now after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. Fielded about a yard deep. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. So out now come the Cardinals. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned it to 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down.
Caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain. So now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
You know, we saw some fun things around the NFL in week six. You had a nose tackle, Dontari Poe, get into the end zone. Kobe Fleeter, a tight end, ran a sweep into the end zone. Interesting week.
The college game does have an influence on the NFL. Kobe Fleeter, that was a jet sweep that normally you see in the college game more than anywhere else. Dontari Poe, they use him really as like an extra tight end, and he caught a pass and really became a lateral, and he dove in. How about in Buffalo? Well, I saw option, and we saw direct snap to LeSean McCoy for touchdowns.
They come up in an empty set. Four wide receivers, one tight end. It's Floyd on the right, and he's brought down after a good game. Got the speed there. He needed the speed and the hands. A great catch.
And because of that speed, you have to respect it as a defender. So you have to either play off or make sure you're somehow in contact with it. And he's able to do exactly what you said. Use the speed to his advantage and go up and get the football. That's a big-time play right there.
Palmer gets to Johnson on the draw. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
Again, it's Johnson. And a short gain here, down to the 22. It'll be a pickup of a couple, and it leaves them with a third and three.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
And this defense looks for one more stop here on third after the run. Palmer now to throw on third down. Able to find Floyd. And oh, it caught it up. And he's going to get this one to the 23-yard line. The Chargers offense now, they get set to head back on the field. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good. So they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. Right side catch. This is Gates. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. Call it a gain of 5. And that'll make this a second down.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
So second and medium, second and 5 now. And he goes in motion here in the backfield. Now a second down throw for Rivers. He sets to fire deep. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
I like the boldness, and I like that they took a shot downfield, but it was well covered, and he's able to get a hand in and knock it away.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. An extra DB added here for the Cards on third.
Blitzer play coverage.
Now Gordon. And some room to run now. Whoa, shifty.
Whoa.
And he's finally taken down, but not before getting across midfield and across the 45-yard line. To Norwood, and he's brought down. It'll go as a gain of 10 there, and the Chargers are going to have a first down. And the offense moving quickly to the line. In motion is the tight end Gates. On first and 10, Rivers. He's going to wind up and air it out. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect.
In this situation, it's really tough to figure out how to defend because they have plenty of room to still take deep shots at the end zone as they just did there. Yet at the same time, you've got to be ready for the short throw. In this case, when you see the cue that they're going for the end zone, retreat and make sure you have a way to play forward back towards the receiver and have a chance to bat the ball away as they did there.
Back to the ground now with Gordon. And he is going to lose yardage here. So he loses 3 yards. Now here's a timeout defensively coming from the Cardinals. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. The defense in an enviable position here. The offense needs 13 yards. It's third down. From the gun, Rivers. This is Gordon on the dump off. Give him 9 on the play, and that'll bring up fourth down.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after.
And now the Cardinals going to use another timeout. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime. They'll pass up a field goal attempt. It would have been a 45-yarder. Now they'll go for it on 4th. Halfback sent in motion. They're going to run. This is Gordon. Melvin Gordon unable to push his way forward. And the Cardinal defense is going to get the football back. And the Cardinals offense here ready to take over. And last time the turnover on the fumble, and they were in enemy territory, so that had to be very frustrating. Down on the scoreboard here, can't do it again.
You nailed every part of what was frustrating. Down on the scoreboard, had a drive going, and pushed it past the 50-yard line so they were in striking distance. And to come away with nothing? Not a good feeling at all, to put it mildly. Now they can't afford to do that again.
Yeah, now can they get that bad taste out of their mouth here? Completes it over the middle to Floyd. Touchdown, Cardinals! Michael Floyd, 50 yards! And the Cardinals are just an extra point away from tying this game. And a little time left on the clock, so on the other side, they're thinking, gosh, we'd like to get that lead right back.
Yeah, thanks for pointing that out. Here I am going ahead and tapping out the first half. There's still time. They've got to make a decision about what they want to do on the kickoff, whether they want to let their return guy touch it.
Now Catanzaro after the touchdown to kick it away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And now San Diego getting set to go. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there can change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
Rivers on first down. Going underneath for Gordon. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. Give him 7 on the play, and it'll make it second down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
And the back goes into motion. Second down, Rivers. He's got his man on the crossing route. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks. So on that play, defense was in the zone. They ran a crossing route offensively, but the defense there, you got to be good with communication, don't you?
You certainly do, and it's not something that is really evident when you watch it on the screen, but everyone's talking,
And a double coverage, and it's intercepted. It's the Honey Badger, Tyrann Mathieu, and his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
And he finds a man with a crossing route. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. Fresh set of downs here.
Let's go, D. Here we go.
On first down, it's Palmer. Now on the run, he'll throw it back deep over the middle. And it's knocked away and incomplete. Jaren Brown, the intended target, and that'll bring us second down.
That's a bold strike right there, taking it downfield and putting some air on it. But how about the coverage? Able to get his hands across the receiver and bat the ball down.
So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. Final play of the half, it's Palmer. Escaping the pressure right. Now he's going to throw deep into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Casey Hayward. And oh, at the end of it, he's stripped. Ball comes loose. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. Two quarters down. Two still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. Now it's Ellington to return. They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. So here's the Cardinals offense now as they get set to start this third quarter. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works.
It's a tried-and-true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball, and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. Here's Palmer to throw. Fitzgerald bringing it in over the middle. It's a 9-yard pickup on the play, and that'll bring up a 3rd and 1. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there. If he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback who has to slide and find open space to throw.
They hand off to their big tight end. And a short gain here, down to the 22. And give him 4 yards there, it'll be 2nd and 6. And after the play on the ground, that brings up 2nd down here. One receiver left, 3 to the right.
Let's go, let's go.
On 2nd down, here's Palmer. Looking for Fitzgerald, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Melvin Ingram. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way. Way back out for their first possession of the second half. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers. Right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
There goes Melvin Gordon. He's at the 50. He's at the 30. And he takes it down deep into enemy territory. It's a big one there for the Chargers. And even 90 yards. So the run moves the chains, and here we go on 1st down. They'll let the fullback try and take him home. It'll be a 3-yard pickup, and it brings up 2nd and goal.
A good solid game there on 1st down, but the defense has to be happy they didn't let it pop for anything bigger.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Now a 2nd down throw for Rivers. And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up 3rd.
Well, we're not playing 3 yards in a cloud of dust football anymore. I kind of get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw the football. Because if it's popped up in the air, it almost turns into slow motion and both sides trying to get to the football, and you're holding your breath wondering whether it's going to go good or bad for your team.
So now 3rd and goal. Will the defense bring some extra pressure here? And no move to take the offense on the field. They're going to stay out there and go for it on 4th and goal.
Now this feels like old school football, because this has turned into a good old...
And he takes it into the end zone across the chalk. Now there is a flag down, but I think that's offsides on the defense.
Yeah, I think that's going to stand, partner.
Big 4th down conversion for the score and the defense. That is a tough pill to swallow.
Big time for them. How about them just deciding to go for it on 4th down? And, forget the field goal, because that looked like an easy 3 points. Yeah, you might have had a defensive breakdown in there, but they pressed the issue and found a way to get it into the end zone. Give them big credit for that.
And the kick goes outside the white lines. That's why the flag comes out.
Yes, and that was an error by the kicker, and it will give the offense great starting field position.
first and 10. It's Palmer. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. Well, switching gears on the walk into the stadium, you and I, we're still talking about Zeke Elliott. I mean, what a start. The guy turned 21 just a few months ago.
I thought this was a passing league, and we're talking about running backs. Isn't it nice, though? It kind of takes me back a little bit. But it's not just him. How about LeSean McCoy in Buffalo in the year he's having? DeMarco Murray has had a revival in Nashville. And don't forget David Johnson in Arizona, a true all-purpose back.
On second down, Johnson. He can't bring him down.
The weight room does work.
9 yards on the pickup there as he'll be left with third and one.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
First across midfield to the 48. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Throwing now, Palmer on first down. Finding time. Completes it over the middle to Floyd. And he's going to get this one down right to the edge of the red zone of the chalk of the 20. And at this stage, down in the second half, looks like they just wanted to find a way to get it in the hands of their playmaker, and they did.
I think you're exactly right. I don't think the coordinator's looking at his play sheet and trying to figure out which play will work well. He's trying to figure out how to get the ball to the playmaker that you just described. Looking down at that sheet, you find people plays, not necessarily X's and O's, and that's exactly what they did there.
Remaining here on second down. Now Palmer to throw on second down. This will be caught just inside the 10. 6 yards on the pickup, and it leaves him with a first and goal. And they're going to hurry back to the line now.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and get the quarterback a really nice target.
So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. They go back to the ground with Johnson. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. They get 3 yards closer, but still work to do. It's third and goal.
We know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. So third and goal, the defense in the dime.
Can still bring pressure.
Now Palmer, that's caught at the 2. Call it a gain of 3. And that will bring up an interesting decision here on fourth and goal.
A short gain that doesn't get them the first down brings up a fourth down situation.
Really nice job defensively. They knew where the sticks were. They got the stop before it. Welcome back to the desert. We're in Glendale. It's Cardinal football, but they trail here as we get set to bring you the fourth and final quarter. Likely the play of the game here, trailing in the final quarter and going for it on fourth and goal. And he is in for 6. Touchdown, Cardinals. Carson Palmer, his second touchdown of the night. And now the Cardinals are within a 2-point conversion of tying up this game. Here we go now as we get set for a big 2-point conversion.
Get ready. Blue 95.
for two, and this game now tied here in the fourth. So here comes the kickoff now, all even here in this fourth quarter. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And now San Diego getting set to go. And that last drive, it was all about the ground game, ground and pound.
And I don't care how we're playing the game these days, offensive linemen still want to fire out and smack the guy opposite them and move the football on the ground. They feel better about that. That's what they want to do. That's how they want to play, and that's how they got it done.
Yeah, and they got it for a touchdown last drive. Let's see what happens here. And he goes in motion here in the backfield. Rivers on first down, caught on the left side by Benjamin. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. It's a gain of 5 on the play, and it's a second down. Second down of the offense needing 5 yards. They come out with one back and 3 tight ends. On second down, they'll run with Gordon. Cuts it out. There goes Melvin Gordon. And all the way down to the 7-yard line. A big play there for San Diego. 63 yards. And now a first down following that long gain. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. It's a gain of 1 yard, and it'll set up 2nd and goal. And quickly, they get to the line. Now Rivers, that's caught at the 3. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. It'll be a gain of 4. And that is going to set up 3rd and goal.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
They'll try and punch it in. Gordon. A loss of 1 yard, and it brings up 4.
He's had a big game tonight. While no one's going to be overly concerned about that last play, you also know that the offense coordinator does not want to see that happen again. They want to get back to doing what they've been doing all game long.
And no movement for the field goal unit to break this tie. They're going to go for this thing. 4th and goal. Here we go. Halfback sent in motion. 4th down. Rivers. Right side catch. This is Gates. And he takes it in for a Charger touchdown. Antonio Gates from 3 yards out. And the Chargers are going to take the lead. And it's no good. Well, that could be a critical miss here in a 1-score game in the 4th. And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. Now it's Ellington to return. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And that last drive was very, very balanced, pretty methodical. You think they go that route again?
I'm always of the school that until they stop me from doing something, I'm going to continue. And I think that that's exactly what they'll look to do. But the beauty is the balance that they've created sets up opportunities for big plays. Looks like a run, turn it into a play action, and throw it one deep. Well, any caused incompletion is good for a defense. But when you add to it that you get a little hit on the quarterback, knock him to the ground, make him think a little bit, hopefully knock him off his game, especially in a game of this magnitude, this tight in the 4th quarter, you got to feel pretty good as a defense.
Get ready. 1, 18.
Second and 10. It's Palmer again, surveying the field. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. The tight end, Jermaine Gresham, the intended receiver. And now it's 3rd down.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense, unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion. On third down, Palmer. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back. Complete. Give him 8 on the play, and that's going to bring up a fourth down.
Partner, I think that completion takes the definition of dink and dunk to a different level, doesn't it?
It does, and the defense was right there, kind of played into their hands. One score down, here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. They come out here in the eye. Giving to the big tight end on fourth. And a gadget play here on fourth down winds up backfiring. And the Chargers will get the football back in excellent field position. Out comes the San Diego offense as they get set to see what they can do here. And it's a unit last drive that did it all on the ground, Charles.
And they controlled it from the interior, big on big, right? Offensive lineman versus defensive lineman. But you know, in order to keep the football moving downfield, other people have to get involved as well. Your wide receivers, your tight ends, lead runners, anything that you have possible to get in front and keep the ball moving.
And now the defense may be looking out for a pass coming up. A second down throw for Rivers. Got a man and he hits him in stride. It's a gain of 9 yards. And that'll make it 3rd and 1.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just
going to
ask you, that wasn't the primary target. He's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
And the offense here just looking to stay in bounds, complete the short passes, and put this game on ice. Play clock winding down. A first down throw here for Rivers. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and brawn. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there, getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker or maybe a defensive end dropping out in a zone blitz, he's going to win that battle just about every time.
On the 7-yard line now. It's 1st and goal. And they'll get him down here at about the 5-yard line. Give him 2 yards on that one. 2nd and goal now.
Just keep the ball on the ground. Do a little pounding. Chew up some clock. If they can get it in, that might be enough to get them home. And if not, the clock is definitely their friend.